Hi, Women in White Coats. This is Dr. Amber, and I'm here chatting with Dr. Archana. Both of us are the co-founders for Women in White Coats, and we just wanted to hop on and talk about something that's been very influential to us and really has helped us in Women in White Coats and in our lives professionally and personally. We want to hop on and talk to you about life coaching and what it is and how it's helped us. So this is a conversation. It's really, really laid back, and we're just going to kind of talk about stuff. I know we were just looking over an article about coaching, and we thought it would be interesting. It was actually published, what was it, Archana, last year?
A year ago now, so October 2019. And you know what the biggest thing is in JAMA, right? And it's a randomized control study about the effect of life coaching for physicians. And the number one thing I got out of it, Amber, is that every physician needs a life coach. Every doctor out there needs to have a life coach, because what was really cool about this study is they actually took, these are all doctors, that they took two groups of doctors. Some were primary care, some were specialists. And they basically gave them a burnout survey, and got a baseline. And then they divided these doctors into two groups, and they did an intervention. The intervention was life coaching. So some of the doctors did not get the life coaching, and some of the doctors did get the life coaching. And then after, I think it was six months of life coaching, they had them do the burnout survey again, and saw some interesting findings. And what they found basically was that the group that had the intervention, which was the life coaching, that they basically had, they gave them that survey again, and they assessed their burnout, and also found that basically their overall sense of burnout was much less. They had less emotional exhaustion. They overall rated their quality of life and resilience better. And so this study basically shows that life coaching makes a big difference. And you know what I think is so interesting, Amber, is how, you know, for so many of us, we think of life coaching as something that is for, you know, C-suite executives or people who are in these high leadership positions at corporations, or for entrepreneurs or for athletes. But I think, in my opinion, every high achiever, like us doctors, need a life coach.
Mm-hmm. I agree. And not even that. I mean, if you also look back at, you know, maybe your childhood, you may have been on a team or a sports team or the debate team, or, you know, even I reflect back as a young girl and learning piano. My piano teacher actually was my coach in a lot of different ways. And I think the thing is, like you were saying, even with high achievers, we think that, okay, well, we're able to make it as doctors to this level. Of course we don't need anyone to help us, because of course we have everything figured out. That's the fallacy out there, right? But realistically, trying to figure out what to do professionally, what to do in your personal life, how things are able to balance out. We're still human beings. In some stages, and depending on what we're trying to do, we're kind of still at infancy, right? So trying to figure out what are the right next steps to take, or do I actually have the solution to my problem and I just never knew it? That's what I find actually a lot of people have the solution, but they just don't know they do to whatever the issue may be.
Yeah. And you know, I think, like, Amber, you raised such a good point that, like, you know, we're doctors, right? We're seen as so successful. We've jumped a lot of hurdles, right? We've made it through a lot. And I actually think that that's exactly, like, why we're kind of like this lost group of people, because then you have, like, a lot of people who maybe have a diagnosis, like maybe like anxiety or depression, and then they're going to see a counselor or a therapist, or they're going to do some, you know, therapy and talk about it. And then there's those of us, you know, who we do all have problems, right? We all have problems no matter how successful we are. We're all going through things that are difficult. But then we oftentimes, because we kind of manage through it, we kind of work through it, we kind of tough it out, we don't talk to people about it, right? So we're kind of just going through all this stuff in our head. And then even in the medical profession, as doctors, we can get really isolated. You know, you have a bad case. You're like, oh, I don't know if I should talk about it. I might get sued about it. I don't want to tell people. Or maybe you're just embarrassed about it. Or there's, you know, there's so many different layers to this where so often we're kind of like lost in that in terms of like, you know, we don't, and furthermore, we oftentimes don't want to go seek counseling or therapy because we're worried about getting this label or something on our record. And we're always so concerned about credentialing that like, oh, when I credential, I have to say if I have any kind of mental health issues that are going to impair me and things like that. And so we're often very, very reluctant to go seek any kind of professional therapy. And that's why I think life coaching is such a needed thing for us, because if we don't want to go talk to a therapist about things, then we need to have somebody to talk to and learn how to manage our minds. And I think like, that's the thing that we were never taught in med school is really how to manage our minds, because these things are going to happen, right? Like it's inevitable that we're going to have a bad outcome with a patient, or it's inevitable that, you know, maybe you run into things like a nurse doesn't want to follow your orders or giving you pushback on your orders, or like a consultant is mean to you, or like you walk into your room to see a patient, especially as women physicians, we get this sometimes, right, Amber, where the patient's like, oh, you're the doctor, you know, and you're just like getting all these different inputs and things that you need to figure out how to process. And, you know, in med school, I certainly didn't learn how to manage my mind. I certainly didn't learn in residency, and I don't think anybody in fellowship teaches it either. But we really need to learn how to manage our mind around all the different things that we run into in being doctors.
Yeah. And you said a couple things there that I want to kind of harp on as well. Don't you think it's crazy. And I use that purposely, crazy for people to think that we don't have any mental things going on as doctors, and to ask us that repeatedly on everything that we go, any job that you apply for, any license you apply for. That in itself is crazy, because if you are someone who is dealing with a lot of people's, externally, you may be dealing with a lot of people's health issues, their emotional issues, mental issues, all of those things, then yes, you yourself will you need to have someone to be able to process that with. That is a heavy, heavy, heavy burden that we are blessed to be able to take care of patients in that way. But if you don't have somewhere where you can put all of that stuff, if you just try to compartmentalize it inside of you, then at the end of the day, or at the end of the year, or at the end of 10, 15 years of doing it, you're going to burn out. There's no way that you can do that. No way at all. And so for me, I have found that having a coach is helpful in that. And the coach, it's different than having a friend who you talk to about it, a colleague who goes through it with you. The purpose of the coach is to be objective, to be able to reflect on you, the things that you've been thinking about, so that together you're able to navigate your thoughts and come up with a solution that works for you. And then what else did you say? You said something else that resonated with me too. Ugh, and I, of course, will forget. I should have wrote it down. But just the fact of having all of that, having all of the things that we have to go through. Oh, this is what you said. You were saying that how a lot of times you don't have training to do this. I am grateful, because now that I know how it is for other residencies, I am grateful that my residency did focus on our mindset, but we didn't recognize it as that. They focused on us learning who we are, us dealing and reflecting on certain situations, but that I find is so rare. That I find is so rare, but it's so needed. And as someone who's worked with residents and have seen like a lot of different things that they go through on the outside as they're attending, and also having a resident who passed away shortly after they completed residency, you know, these are things that we are, it grows over time. All of this hardship grows over time. And the thing is, what do we do with it? Are we going to make it into a positive thing, or are we going to just stay in the negative and just, you know, just go to work, be a robot? So life coaching, having a coach is really good to be present. I know for me, my thing was when I worked on stress reduction, because this girl is stressed out a lot. And so over 10 years from trying to get into medical school, to being in medical school, to being in residency, to being in fellowship, my hair was falling out. And I didn't know why. I was trying to figure out, was it what I was putting in my hair? Was it how I was doing my hair? Nothing really changed over the 10 years from what I did the 10 years prior, other than being in medicine.
Yeah, exactly.
And it caused my hair to fall out. But then when I was working with my coach on a regular basis to figure out, okay, so the circumstance of being in medicine isn't going to change. That's something that you are choosing to do, right? But how I approach it, what I look for, how I internalize or choose not to internalize things, that's what we have control over. And guess what? My hair started growing.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, Amber, you make so many good points there. I mean, what are we going to do with all this stress, the crazy expectations? But not only that, like, we as physicians tend to be almost like the perfect setup for burnout, like, right? Because we're like very perfectionistic. We have no compassion for ourselves, right? And we expect to, I think the medical training kind of makes you that way, where you're like, I have to be perfect all the time. You know, this, so it really drives home that perfectionist attitude. And then we don't allow any compassion to ourselves. We are almost treated in our training that, like, we should never go to the bathroom. We shouldn't need to eat. You should just stand in this 10-hour surgery and never scrub out, you know? And it's like, that's reinforced, you know, we're already kind of like a self-selected group of bias, kind of like martyrs in a way. And then you add in the training and it makes us more of that way. And then we're like, any kind of weakness, we can't show any kind of weakness, right? And so it's just like the perfect setup for burnout. And what's interesting is, like, I, through coaching, have overcome like multiple rounds of burnout over the years. So for those of you who felt burnt out and you're like, oh, it's coming back again, like, you know, it certainly can happen again. It doesn't necessarily mean like you go through it once and then you never have it again. But I think that, you know, there's so many different, like, coaching can really help you overcome it, you know, all the different things that you're going through. And when I first started receiving life coaching, I was like, my whole life, like, I need to talk about my whole life, because on so many different levels of my life, I needed coaching on it. And I had never really learned just this whole concept of, like, you know, there's what happened, there's the facts of what happened or what's happening. And then there's the story I'm making it mean, right? There's this meaning I'm giving to it. And we get to choose that meaning, right? Like, we get to choose what it means that, like, you know, somebody, there was, you know, that maybe you were late to arriving to an appointment, and you could, like, beat yourself up and be like, oh, I'm such an awful person. I'm somebody who's always late, you know? Or you could be like, okay, well, I'm going to be compassionate about myself. And yeah, you know, there's traffic or something happened at home and my kids were like crying as I was trying to leave out the door. You know, it's just like, you could make it mean whatever you want it to mean. And you've got to choose those thoughts as to what thought is really going to serve you, and how, you know, just really being conscientious of, like, your mind and managing it so that you're choosing thoughts that are actually going to help you instead of harm you.
Mm-hmm. And a lot of times it does start there. I know for me, it started with forgiving myself. My coach used to say, Amber, you have to be able to say, I forgive myself for putting myself in the position where now I feel like I'm pushing more to be a professional than being a person. Like, you know, having different phrases like that, where you have to forgive yourself, because being a perfectionist does not really lend itself for that. And then also, like you were saying, being in a culture of medicine that was designed for men, let's remember that, where men have this whole different mindset of how they address the world. I am learning that as a newlywed. It's completely different than how we address the world as women. So knowing that culture was built for men who may not be as or show their emotions as much, to then being a woman in that culture, you know, really the way that we see things, the way that we feel things, the way that we express ourselves is different. And for that, not saying that men don't need life coaching, because, you know, they do as well. But also for us, knowing that we are creating a special space in medicine we are creating a special space for those who are coming after us. We are creating a new culture of medicine. And that culture is, in my opinion, or should be, in my opinion, around wellness and making sure that we're okay. Taking care of patients is a great thing to do, but if you're not okay and you're sinking and you're drowning, then there's no way you can save anyone else, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I think it goes back to something I heard somebody say recently, which was that a happy doctor leads to happy patients and healthy patients, you know? So if you don't have a happy doctor who's taking care of themselves, like how can you really truly take care of other people? One of the classic examples is like the overweight doctor who's telling their patient like, hey, you're overweight, you need to lose weight, your BMI is too high. And like the patient is not gonna like, you know, the first thought they're gonna have is like, well, look at you, like you're not even healthy yourself, or you're like super stressed out, or, you know, talking to patients about stress management. It's like, well, okay, if you're super stressed out and look like, you know, you're not managing your stress very well, then how are they going to really receive that information from you? Because it really does come down to living that example, right? Mm-hmm. And, you know, I think that that's one of the key things about it, is just really living the example and being that the best version of yourself for others. And we as physicians are multipliers, right? Like what we do impacts all the patients that we see and the, you know, who are in our practice. And we're also seen as role models in the community. So the healthier we can be, the more of an impact we can make out there in the world.
Exactly. Exactly. And so the great thing that I love about Women in White Coats is that we understand that because we've been there. We've been there, and we get you, and we get that other women are going through this. And the thing is, we just don't talk about it. And because we don't talk about it, we don't have a solution for it, right? You feel like you're alone trying to figure this out by yourself. But there are other people who've been there, done that. And the good thing or great thing is that we know how to make it better. And so is it okay if we talk about what we've come up with?
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
So we've come up with a way to do that. And this is a love project for us because we're able to help women doctors just like you be able to combat all those things, burnout, exhaustion, trying to figure out what the next steps are for you. And we call it
Life by Design. Yay. Yeah, I'm so excited for this, Amber. Like So today is really launch day for it. October 1st is the day that we've kind of were like, oh, we're launching this. But honestly, yeah, this has been something that we've been dreaming of creating for our tribe and our community, because we've seen women doctors go through so many different things. Like as we've already been mentioning, you know, everything from burnout to lack of taking time for self-care, also difficult relationships, you know, personal things that are going on, imposter syndrome, so many different things, overeating, over drinking, overworking, like all of these things really come down to the fact that we need to manage our minds. We need some life coaching on these things. So that's why we've created Life by Design, like coaching for women doctors. And it's our brand new membership. And we want to invite all of you listeners to check it out, to join in. And one of the really cool things I love about it, Amber, is that everybody who's a member is going to get weekly coaching from a physician life coach. And for right now, that's going to be either Amber or I. But as the community grows, we will be adding additional physician life coaches. And you'll get to have coaching with us. Bring any topic that you want. One-on-one, we'll go through it. We'll talk through it. We'll help you have a mindset shift. And one of the things that I always love, Amber, when I coach someone is like, I can literally see their shoulders drop. Like at the end of the session, they're like, oh, I never thought about it that way. Like, gosh, that just like takes all this weight off of my shoulders, you know, of just reframing it and thinking about it in a different way and managing our thoughts and having a plan of like, okay, what would actually be a better way of thinking about this or a better way of approaching this? And it's just, I love that feeling of just seeing like the weight lift off of them when they come up with a different way of approaching it.
Yeah, because a lot of times we get into the analysis paralysis, right? You're thinking about things and you keep thinking about it, and then you keep thinking about it and you have thoughts about it, and then it's negative thoughts after negative thoughts after negative thoughts, and then you get buried in it. But then, like, wait a minute. Wait, we are able to help you say, let's take a pause, a chill pill, and be able to really look at things for what they are and look at things in a way that we can, like you said, kind of retrain our brains in a positive way. So we're not just bashing ourselves over and over again, because that's what we do. That's what we're trained to do. So our work with you will be about retraining. That's what I want to say. Retraining your brain so that you won't do that. So that you can look and look for the positive things in life, that you can be present in life, that you can be able to be your real authentic self and be okay with it. So yeah. Yes. So, and I think it's really cool that we're going to be doing it on a weekly basis. Like that in itself, you know, having the opportunity to do that on a weekly basis, whether you need it or not, it's a great, great, great thing to have. And not only that, you also have access to our doctor's lounge. And that is a super, super cool place where you can learn about so many different things in medicine, whether you're thinking about real estate or you're thinking about having your own practice or you're thinking about even introducing things like marijuana in your practice. Like, we have had some interesting topics there to unleash a lot of our limitations that we think medicine has put on us and allow us to dream even bigger. So I'm excited about that.
Yeah, and we also have, when you become a member of Life by Design, you'll also get access to group coaching and workshops that we've done on very specific topics, burnout and wellness and setting up a self-care routine and, you know, how to work through difficult things we see at work, keeping your heart open and not closing down your emotions from all the sad and tragic things that many of us see at work. So we've got all of that too, because sometimes I find that actually just watching someone else get coached or doing a workshop on something or just kind of diving deeper into a particular topic can really help move the needle and help you as well. Like sometimes so many of us are really going through a lot of similar things. And so yes, seeing somebody else get coached on it or work through that same exact problem that you're having can be so incredibly powerful. And with regards to the one-on-one coaching, we've really kept it, like, you know, perfect for busy working women, because we're going to be doing like laser coaching. So in just 20 minutes, in a 20 minute session, you're going to get something really impactful and powerful. We're going to work through whatever topic that you bring to us and help you really reframe your mind and get to a place where, you know, you're able to get those results that you want to get in life. And so many times I think we think that all these things have to change, all the circumstances have to change, you know, for us, you know, to be happy, right? The pandemic has to go away, or like this, my schedule has to be better, or like all these different things, these external circumstances have to change. But what we're going to show you as your coaches is that sometimes you can change those things and sometimes you can't. And if it's the case that you can't change those things, what you can always change and what you always have control over is your mind and your thoughts and what thoughts you're going to choose to think. And we're going to teach you how to think things that are going to help you and that are going to uplift you and empower you. And I'm just so incredibly excited, and I can't wait to start working with all of you guys and getting to know you better through these sessions.
Yeah, it's really the gift that keeps on giving. We were able to experience the gift of having a coach, and, you know, we hope that you will be able to experience the gift of having a coach. And I know after being coached, you'll find that you'll also want to spread this great news to other people. So I am excited as well. It's going to be an exciting time just to see transformation. That's what we love to do, seeing you being able to live your best life. So we believe, and we were talking about this before, that every doctor, what did you say, Archana?
Every doctor needs a life coach. And yeah, so if you don't have one yet and you want to check out coaching, you want to experience what it's all about, And, you know, you also don't necessarily have a lot of time to invest in like long coaching sessions every week. This is going to be the perfect opportunity for you. It's perfect for busy working women, women doctors like yourselves. So head on over to womeninwhitecoats.com/coaching and you can learn more about it. And we can't wait to have you be a part of our Life by Design community. And the reason we called it Life by Design is because we want you to have the life of your dreams and the life that you intended to have in every area of your life. So not just your career, but also in your personal life, in your relationships, and in every single area of your life. And through coaching, we know that you can achieve that.
Yay. So join us there and check us out on our next podcast.